In this video, I'm going to show you what to do to recover from a sudden rankings drop. I'm going to walk you through the things that I've seen in my career as an SEO that typically cause or lead to these sudden rankings drops so that you can quickly run through this checklist and mitigate the problem. Okay, before we get into the actionable checklist, I just want to remind you, take a deep breath, don't panic. I know it's easy for me to say when it's not my site, but I've dealt with a lot of people in a lot of these situations, and I can't tell you how many times I've gotten an email or a call, and two or three days later, this cleared itself up pretty much on its own, and it was just a random blip. So step one is to review any big changes. Pretty obvious, but if you've changed the navigation, if you've redirected pages, go back and check those redirects. Or maybe you redirected something a month ago. Go back and check. I was just talking with an enterprise client today and their old redirects just stopped working. So you want to go and double check all of those changes that you've recently made and make sure that they're still in place, still proper, and not causing any issues. Next thing you want to do is to look externally at some tools, and they are algorithm change monitors, and I have three of them and they're all pretty good. I'll show you the first one, which is from Mozcast. It is Moz has had this kind of weather report for a long time. If you see it and it's really hot and stormy, like it was on Thursday, August 10th, you know that some changes are afoot. I'll show you advanced web rankings as well, and I'll link all these in the description. But what you'll want to look for is more patterns. See on the 10th, they're showing changes as well. So kind of like high activity right in that range. And SEMrush is a new entry into this field, and their sensor tool is quite good. I really like it because it also offers categories. So you can see right here that, you know, sports and news are being more affected than other categories. You can actually enter your own site and get a personal score for your own rankings, which is really nice. And you can flip between mobile and desktop. And again, if we look here, see the 10th and 11th, they're kind of showing in that same range as the other tools, some high activity. So using these all together kind of gives you an idea if some ranking changes are rolling out as we speak. The next thing you're gonna do is you're gonna wanna go to Search Console. It used to be Webmaster Tools, but Google changed the name to Search Console. If you don't have an account, get one. It's free, easy to activate with tools like Yoast if you're on WordPress. First thing you wanna check is messages, and just see if Google has left you a message telling you you have some issues. And you'd be surprised a lot of times that they're having issues crawling something. They'll leave a message right there for you detailing exactly what the issue is. Now, this is a, we just moved our site to HTTPS literally, and it's still propagating. So I'm not gonna have really any data in this account, but I'm using this just to show you. You go here to messages. Then you're going to go down the list and you're going to check for manual actions. You're going to check pretty much everything in crawl. So in search traffic, you'd select manual actions. Now, a lot of people, they think if there's no manual action, they haven't been penalized, but it's more rare to get a manual action. That means like someone at Google literally, you know, reviewed this and manually applied a penalty to you, and you will get a message there. So check that and make sure that's not the case. But a lot of times that doesn't mean you didn't get an algorithmic penalty or some algorithmic action that the algorithm itself without human intervention just did to your site. And so that wouldn't show up here in manual actions, but do check that. You're also gonna wanna go down to crawl errors. Check all of these. Check for, you know, big errors and crawl stats. I want you to go fetch as Google. So pick out some of your pages and fetch and render them and make sure you're not seeing anything crazy. Go to Robots.txt Tester. Make sure that you're not seeing any errors or warnings, you know, blocking. I can't tell you how many times I've seen a new website go up and they forgot to update robots.txt because they were blocking it on staging, blocking Google. And then they update the new site with the blocked robots.txt and they lose all their rankings. Also look at security issues just in case. This is if your site maybe got hacked and it's displaying malware. Obviously, Google would not want to rank you if that's the case. So checking these will give you a really good idea. Mainly, you're looking at your index, your crawl stats. Is Google okay with your sitemap? That kind of stuff. So if you go in here and you see tons of sitemap errors, you know, that could be an issue. The next is to go look at technical issues. Now, this is a little harder to talk about in just one video, but this would be hosting issues. So look, let's say you are using HTTPS. Make sure you don't have any issues with your SSL certificates. Or are you using a content delivery network like Max CDN to speed up your site? Make sure everything is rosy there and not causing problems. Many people use cache. So like I use WordPress fastest cache on my WordPress site. If that's not set up properly or something went squirrely, caching can cause a lot of problems if it's not working right. So lastly, I would say a lot of people will fall into the bucket of there is a real-time kind of penalty being applied to them. And that penalty is usually a penguin or a panda penalty. So these used to be kind of manually run very infrequently by Google, but they've been moved into the real-time algorithm. And I'm going to be very broad here, but penguin, if you just had to say one thing it's about your backlinks, okay? And panda is about the quality of your content. And so these are now running in Google's core algorithm. So what you're going to want to do for penguin is you're going to want to check and see if you have a lot of keyword rich backlinks to your site. If you do there and you're seeing a big rankings drop, it could be a really good sign that you've been affected by penguin. For panda, if you're going to want to look at the quality and depth of your content, you're going to look at how long people are scrolling and staying on the site. If they just leave right away, it could be signaling that your content quality is thin. So thin content that doesn't provide a lot of value is usually the issue with panda. Let me give you a free tool to use to check your backlinks. Obviously, you know, I'm a big fan of Moz, SEMrush, you know, hrefs for checking backlinks. But this is free right now, and it is openlinkprofiler.org. I kind of did a chuckle when I went there because I did not know they were using one of my tweets saying, hey, to check them out. But obviously, that's cool with me, and it's a really cool tool. What you're focused on are your anchor text. We could get into, maybe I'll do a video on SEO Profiler at some point and show you some of the cool stuff you can do. But you're looking here, and if you see things like your name, Gergich and Company, Gergich, Gergich, AJ Gergich, that's me, your URL, you're good to go if that's the majority of your links. But if you're seeing, instead of here, you saw something like SEO Agency, SEO Consultant, and there were tons of links in here, you would be at risk for a penguin penalty because you're using too many, you know, keyword rich, non-natural links to your site. Most people are going to link to you by your brand name or someone's name there at your company or a tool that you have, something branded to you. And if Google's not seeing that, it's going to think you're manipulating. And so that would be, you know, you would need to clean that up. Just Google articles on how to clean up penguin penalties. It mostly revolves around you removing those backlinks, writing them, emailing them, trying to get them down, and then disavowing all of those links in Search Console. Let me know down in the comments if this kind of rankings, sudden rankings drops has ever happened to you, and maybe how you got out of the problem or what the problem actually ended up being. It's interesting to just kind of learn from each other through our experiences. I'll see you guys in the next video.